we're going to look at in this lesson is something called a rate expression. It is a way of defining a rate of a reaction by monitoring the change of any reactant or product. It is a continuation of what we looked at last time, but now we need to incorporate coefficients that aren't always one, okay? So not all substances are going to appear or disappear at the same rate of speed. And so you've got to make sure you take into account that when you're comparing between things, that you always get the same value out. In order to do this, I'm going to do a little simple demonstration here. We'll fill in this table and be able to come up with, let me put this somewhere nice, values to plug into this table with a very simple demonstration. Now I've got a timer, so let me put my timer on. And we're going to time it for 30 seconds. Okay? And so we're going to have a 30-second demonstration from start to finish. Before we get started, we want to count how many pieces of paper we have and how many booklets we made. We're going to actually be doing, and let me go ahead and go to this next slide, a demonstration of the reaction 2A goes to B. So here's what's going to happen. I am going to take my stack of paper and I'm going to take two pieces of paper and I'm going to fold them together and make one booklet. So two pieces of paper turns into one booklet. Now what I have started here with are 12 pieces of paper. You're going to take my word on that because I don't want to have to spend time counting them. I have 12 pieces of paper and I have no booklets, okay? So let's go ahead and see how many booklets we can make, and this is going to be riveting video here, me making these booklets in 30 seconds. Okay, so I take two pieces of paper, I fold them in half, booklet one. Take two pieces of paper, fold them in half, you get the picture. I won't claim that my rate of speed is constant throughout this whole thing, but there we go. Oh, there's my timer. Okay, so hit that, and we can now make a count of what we've got at this point. All right, so I have made 1, 2, 3, 4 booklets. So the booklets is 4. Okay, and the paper, what do I have left? I have 4 pieces of paper left, okay? So I started with 12, I dropped down to 4. I started with no booklets, and I created 4, okay? So there's the demonstration. Now let's look at how this is 2A turns into B, right? Let's look at that reaction, and let's think about how their rates compare. I want you to come up with an answer on this. Does B appear twice the rate that A disappears? Okay, remember is the booklets. Does A disappear twice as fast as B is appearing? Or does A disappear at the same rate B appears? Think about these numbers and what's happening. Well, without having a reaction, without having mathematics fully, just looking at these numbers and thinking about it, I hope you see that A is disappearing twice as fast. Look at these numbers. I dropped down 8. 8 of those got consumed, while only 4 of these got made. So I have that disappearing twice as fast as this is appearing. Now let's go ahead and make measurements of this, okay? If we wanted to do a change in A with respect to time, okay, what is the change of A? It's 4 minus 12 over the 30 seconds, okay? And we can get a number for that. And let's see, I calculated the numbers for all sorts of different possibilities of what I did, and this is 4 booklets. When I use up that many pieces of paper, okay, and take 4 minus 12 divided by that, I get 0.266, and I call it per second, okay? Booklets per second, pieces of paper per second, that's what this is. Change per second. And that would be a negative value because it's a little number minus a big number. If I did the change in B with respect to time, okay, I do 4 minus 0 over those 30 seconds, and I get 0.133 of these being used or created in this case per second. So now we can see number wise that this is disappearing twice as fast as this is appearing. Now, which one of these is the rate of the reaction? In our previous lesson, we said we can monitor any reactant, any product, and get a rate of the reaction. But these rate of changes are different from each other. But how would we make them equal to each other? What could I do to one that would make it the same as the other? And use the coefficients in the process. Well, it would look like this. If I took this, okay, and I changed its sign, so I'm multiplying by another negative, okay, a negative of a negative is a positive. And what else am I doing? I'm also dividing by 2. Then it would equal this, wouldn't it? So A has a 2 coefficient. I have to divide by the coefficient. Since A is a reactant, I have to change the sign and make it positive. So I could say the rate of the reaction is this number, 0.113, rate is equal to either a negative of a negative 0.266 over 2, which is doing this divided by its coefficient, or it's this one, which is a product, so I don't need the negative sign. It's already positive, and I'm not dividing by, I can put a 1 there if I wanted to, but I get the same number either way I do it. So the rate of the reaction is 0.133 something, can't be molarity, per second. Items, that's what I'll call it, items per second. And that will give me a good numerator to be consistent with. So now we can say it for any generic reaction. We can incorporate the coefficients. So here we see A and B are my reactants, C and D are my products. The little A, the little B, little C, little D, those are the coefficients of the reaction. And where do those coefficients come into play? Well, they come into play in the denominator. So the reactants have a minus sign in there, and we're dividing by the coefficient. The products don't have a minus sign in there, but we're still dividing by the coefficient. So the rate can be determined by monitoring any one of those things. Now, would you have to monitor all of them in order to know the rate of the reaction? Well, no. You don't have to monitor everything to know how fast the reaction is. You pick a substance that it's easy to monitor, and not everything is. You put some acid and a base together in a reaction chamber, it has no color, you can't see it. You have to take a word that it's acidic because we stuck a piece of pH paper in it or whatever. We knew how we made it up. We take an acid, we take a base, we mix them together, it neutralizes. There's nothing to see. It's hard to monitor. But some things are easier to monitor than others. And so you find the thing that you can develop a technique for monitoring how it changes with time. Choose that one thing and you can determine the rate of the reaction by monitoring the change in concentration as time goes by. The easiest things to do this for are things that change color, because we have little devices called colorimeters which will monitor the color change in the absorption of light, or form a gas, because you can measure the formation of that gas pretty easily by monitoring the pressure change. So there's some things that are easy to monitor as time goes by. Okay, so sometimes you're going to be reading through and they'll ask about something about rate, and we're going to learn a couple different ways of determining the rate. So if ever they use the expression that you're going to write a rate expression for a reaction in terms of the disappearance of reactants or the formation of products, this is what they're talking about, okay? They're asking for this sort of thing. Because here in a little bit, we're going to learn about rate laws, and that is something that gets us the rate, but by a different means. This is really by means of the definition of rate, how the concentration changes as time goes by. The other way will be a way of doing it where you don't have to monitor the change, and we'll talk about that later. So let's see how we would work these problems. The first one here tells me that, and look at, let me go over to the screen here where I can point on some things. Look at what we have here. BrO3 is a reactant, Okay, so we're seeing how the reactant changes as time goes by, and somebody monitored that over a certain interval. And they went ahead and put the minus sign in there to turn it into a positive value. So what they are saying is that BrO3 is disappearing at a rate of 1.5 times 10 to the minus 2 molarity per second. All right, so that's one thing they're giving me. They're wanting to know, well then, how fast is Br minus disappearing? That's another reactant. So if I had a problem like this, I would say, well, I have a way of relating these guys. The rate of change of the rate of the reaction can be monitored in terms of the change in BrO3, okay, with respect to time, and put a minus in there. That would give me the rate of the reaction. And they told me that the value for this is 1.5 times 10 to the minus 2. We could also do this in terms of Br. Now, how would that be different? Well, Br, we're monitor the change in concentration of Br minus with respect to time. Since it's a reactant, we'll put a minus sign in there. And then we know in order for these to be actually equal to each other and actually equal to the rate, there's one other thing we need. What is that thing? Well, we need a 5 here, okay? We need to divide by 5. So in this problem, it says, well, what is the rate of change with respect to bromine, Br minus, the bromide ion? Well, they're asking for that part right here, so I just have to get rid of the 5. How do I get rid of the 5? I multiply by 5, okay? And when I take 1.5 times 10 to the minus 2 molarity per second and multiply by 5, I'm going to get the answer. This is how Br minus is being consumed, okay? This is the rate at which Br minus is being consumed. Let me underline it, okay? So they're showing it to me in symbols, okay? But the language is, at what rate is Br minus being consumed? It is being consumed at a rate of 7.5 times 10 to the minus 2 molarity per second. At what rate is BrO3 minus being consumed? It's being consumed at a rate of 1.5 times 10 to the minus 2. But if they said, what is the rate of the reaction? The rate of the reaction would be the same number regardless of whether you did it in terms of the BrO3 minus or in terms of the Br minus. All right, let's look at the next problem. In this problem, they're telling me that Br minus disappears at this rate. Okay? Well, that's what we just figured out on the previous slide. They want to know, in this case, how fast is Br2 appearing? So I have Br minus being compared to Br2. Well, I can know that the rate of the reaction would be equal to either way I monitor it. I could monitor it in terms of Br minus, so it would be the change in concentration of Br minus with respect to time, and then divide by a 5. Or in terms of Br2, I look up here, I would not need the negative sign because this is already positive, okay? And I have a 3 in there. They are telling me this part, circling what they're telling me, the rate of change of Br minus, it is disappearing at this rate. What they're wanting is how fast is this appearing, and I'll put a little cloud around it. That's what I'm trying to solve for. Okay, so I can plug in what I know, 7.5 times 10 to the minus 2, and divide it by 5 would be equal to what I'm looking for, which I'll call it x divided by 3. So if I multiply both sides by 3, I will get the rate of appearance of Br, which is what x is, it's all that stuff in the cloud, of 4.5 times 10 to the minus 2. Now I'm going to go to the board, and I'm going to work this problem in a different fashion. It's the same problem, but we're going to use dimensional analysis a little bit differently. We've got our balanced equation, okay? And let's see how our coefficients could play out in a little bit different way. So I know this, and let me move down here below. So this is the same problem. I know that 7.5 times 10 to the minus 2 Molarity is moles per liter, and this is what substance? This is Br minus. So moles of Br minus disappearing, I'm going to put DIS for disappearing, per liter, that's molarity, per second. Okay, that is molarity per second. But I really don't want moles of Br minus disappearing. I want moles of, what's the other substance? Br2 appearing, and I'll put AP for appearing, okay? I just go to my balanced equation and I see that 3 moles of this appears every time 5 moles of that disappears. So in a similar fashion as to what I did on the screen there, is I'm dividing by 5 and multiplying by 3. This is a way of letting those units do the work for me. So this is canceling, and what am I left with? I'm left with 4.5 times 10 to the minus 2 moles of Br2 appearing per liter over seconds, or molarity per second. And that is another way of thinking through this using the rate expression, which is what we were developing here, okay? So those are typical kinds of problems where you're given how fast something's appearing and asked how fast something is disappearing. What if the question asked, what is the rate of the reaction? Is the rate of the reaction that number? No. Is the rate of the reaction that number? No. The rate of the reaction would be this number divided by its coefficient. What was the coefficient of the Br minus? If you look at the problem there, the Br minus had a coefficient of 5. So this value divided by 5 would be the rate of the reaction. Is the rate of the reaction this number? No. This is the rate of appearance of Br2. I look at my coefficient of that, and I see that there's a 3 coefficient. So the rate that this is appearing divided by 3 would be how I would define the rate of the reaction. And you'd get the same number in either case. So sometimes they'll ask, what's the rate of change of a substance? How fast is this disappearing? How fast is this disappearing? Or they might say, what's the rate of the reaction? And depends upon what they're asking for. But when you see the word rate that I have written on there, that's the rate of the reaction. Can be defined by any one of these things being monitored and dividing by their coefficients. Okay, let's see if there's anything else here. Next up. What we're going to do is see that monitoring, well, I'll just tell you this right now. Monitoring how concentration changes with time is very difficult, okay? So we're going to learn something called a rate law, which is another way of obtaining the rate of a reaction where you don't have to monitor changes in concentration.